Hi, I'm Johnny with your latest music news. First up, we're just hours away from the 30th annual Brit Awards. The set has been built, the awards are being polished, and the dance routines have been practiced to death. With performances from JLS, Lady Gaga, Kasabian, and even a duet between Florence Welch and Dizzy Rascal, the anniversary bash is set to be a big one. Listen. You Got the Dirty Love, a mashup between Dizzy's Dirty Cash and Florence's cover of You've Got the Love, is going to be released tomorrow on iTunes to raise money for the Brit Trust. As well as on their own sets, all those performing artists will be keeping an eye on the winners' podium as they're all up for awards. JLS have three between them, including British Breakthrough and Best Single. I caught up with them on Saturday to ask how they're feeling ahead of the ceremony.
You know what, we haven't even really thought about the awards, we've just been thinking about the performance. Mm-hmm. We've had a choreographer in from America who choreographed our third video, One Shot, and it's literally been so intense that we've just really been excited about what our performance is going to be like. You know, we want it to be the best JLS performance, you know, yet. So for us, we're feeling a lot of pressure, but we're just kind of staying focused on the game. And if anything happens on the night, then, you know, it'll be fantastic. It'll be a major bonus.
Good luck, fellas. Lucrezia is going to be at the awards tonight, so she'll be bringing you the very latest on all the winners. Next up, you'd think they might rest on their laurels after beating Joe McElderry to last year's Christmas number one, but Rage Against the Machine are doing anything but that. They've just been announced as headliners for this year's Download Festival in Donington Park, alongside Aerosmith. It's the icing on a very busy month of June for the band. As well as headlining Download, they're playing Dublin on the 8th of June, as well as the free London gig they promised to celebrate their win over the X Factor. Tickets for the London show were allocated by lottery, so if your number didn't come up, then Download is your best bet to catch them in concert. And finally, it gave birth to one of the most iconic album covers ever, but now it's finally up for sale. EMI, owners of the Abbey Road Studios in London, have put them up for sale after over 70 years of ownership. EMI are hoping for a selling price in the millions to help them out of their considerable debt, though there's no word yet on whether the sale would include the Abbey Road brand as well as the property. The studios have played host to artists from Blur and the Beatles to Sir Edward Elgar, and even played their part in Second World War propaganda recordings. You know, I might have a whip round, I always really fancied my own studio. Anyway, that's your lot from me for now. Keep your eyes on us for all the latest on the Brit winners.